Good morning, people. How are we doing? I am feeling refreshed. I mean, it is past 12 o'clock, so good afternoon, people. Today is a very exciting day, but I'm not actually sure how much, number one, I'm going to be able to say. Number two, how much I'm actually going to be able to show. So, I told you about that fox stealing my pants. He's then taken a red shirt of Mum's, and if you look down that garden just there, can't see it, there are two pairs of socks. They're little. But we are starting off the day with brunch. Lizzie and I are going to have some food. We've just ordered it. We've also ordered some iced coffees because we don't have any coffee in the house, and I should have just gone out and got some. We also don't have ice, so it's just easier if I order it. But if today goes well, it could be something very exciting for the future. But I'm not putting all of my eggs in one basket. It's just a really exciting opportunity. Something's happening today, something's happening on Tuesday. Both those days are going to be slightly smaller content. But that's all right. I just need to be at somewhere at 6. That last clip was at 1 o'clock. I came in and I've started watching The Slice of Jess on the telly, and it's now 3:22. I fell asleep. That's not ideal, but luckily I woke up about 40 minutes before my alarm even went off, so I knew that I was going to fall asleep. That's why I said, who is texting me at the O2? You, me, boxing match, undercard for Logan Paul, me v O2. Actually, no, O2 do quite a lot for me, so should probably thank them. Oh, why am I so tired? I've just had a 2-hour nap. I am probably going to leave in about an hour to get on the tube and get into central London for this thing that I'm not quite sure if I'm allowed to tell you or if I am allowed to tell you. I'm sure I am allowed to tell you. I haven't had to sign any NDAs yet, so I'm sure that's fine. I'm going to text my agent and find out, because I'd love to tell you guys what is going on. I managed to film a whole scene, get to the last word, and it went, battery exhausted. Great. Anyway, I've got a new hat on. We've had a shower. We're ready to go to this place that you guys will be able to find out what it is now. I just texted Georgina, my agent, and was like, is there any NDAs? Can I tell the vlog? I haven't been telling the vlog, but am I allowed? She's like, yeah, no NDAs, so just go for it. So, I am going to see a film called Prey, which is on Disney Plus, which comes out August 5th. And I've actually been asked by Disney Plus, which has blown my mind, to go and interview Dan Trachtenberg, who is the director of the film. What? As this is my first time doing this sort of thing, I'm absolutely terrified, but I have amazing people around me, and I'm off to see Georgina on Monday to talk through the questions and everything, and I'm really excited, because if this is something that I enjoy, then I can maybe move on to other things and interview other people, and hopefully that will lead to other things, which is really, really exciting, but also terrifying to have this as my first one. Because I absolutely love 10 Cloverfield Lane, which he directed. Also, he directed The Boys on Amazon, which I also really enjoyed. But I get to see the film today, and it is a film that has been on my list. So when Georgina told me about it, I was like, yes, I will do it. It's so out of my comfort zone, interviewing people. I'm normally either the one being interviewed or the one watching the interview. I'm never the person sat in the junket or sitting in the junket, asking the questions. So I'm going to have to take a notebook today, figure out some important things to ask, because I only have 10 minute slot next Tuesday. You guys know it, it's another hat change, but I'm also going to take my Jurassic Park notebook that is my lucky one, but also I got given on the first day that I started at Windsor by my mum. And in the front of it is all of Lizzie's dates that she went to with everybody talking about Jamie, with all of the dates, because I did a thing where I picked out a film every week for her to watch, and in some of them it had like locations to go for food, some of them were locations to go for a drink after work, some of them had some money in so that I could buy her a drink while she was on tour, and yeah, I forgot that I did it in this notebook, and now I've got it for Prey. So let's go and see this film. We are in the hustle and bustle of Leicester Square. It seems to be incredibly busy. This is now officially summer for some people. Also, Greggs is open in Leicester Square. I need to go in there because I want to try more Greggs. So I feel like I'm gonna, oh my God, they're shut for the day because they've run out of stuff. I'm not surprised, to be honest. I am not surprised. But yeah, we aren't seeing the film until 6. So I'm meeting with my mate David, who came to all of my screenings with me. And he's just an all-round top guy. And I haven't seen him in a while, so I'm going to... I'm just going to go and meet him for a coffee before I need to go in, to calm my nerves a little bit. Just got to the Covent Garden Hotel where the screening is, and it is just past 6:02, and the organisers aren't here yet, which is fine, it's all good. They'll be here, but everyone here, I don't know who they are, so kind of daunting, but no, all good. I watched the trailer again for the film and it looks so good. I'm really excited to watch it, and I think by the looks of it, everyone out here is like an influencer slash maybe journalist. Don't know if they're actually a journalist because they'll be watching in a different screen. I don't know. So we're just out of the film. I really enjoyed it. I thought that was a great film. From someone who has never seen Predator, any of the Predators before, I understood it from start to finish, loved it. I thought there was amazing action, I thought the acting was amazing, I thought the casting was amazing, there were a few comedy lines in there, so the writing was great. I really, really enjoyed that. I kind of didn't quite know what to expect going into it, but then halfway through the film I was like, oh, I am fully invested. Actually, it wasn't even halfway through the film, it was like, within the first 10 minutes, I was like, I'm into this film, I like it. I'm now going to the Ivy Club, but later on, I will be going back and watching the rest of the Predators, as that's really taken me by shock that I loved it that much. Not that film in particular, but like, I've never seen any of them before and been told really good things about the Predator films, and always like, kind of missed out on it, I feel. So I ended up moving from the Ivy because it just was a bit busy in the Ivy, and I just couldn't really concentrate. So I went to my favourite coffee shop, bar type place, that I'm not going to give out the name of still. You probably all know where it is if you know the vlogs and know the area. But the editing is done, but their Wi-Fi wasn't strong enough to put up my vlog. So Lizzie and I are just going to head home in an Uber that arrived in a minute. Last night we were waiting for 25 minutes for a cab, and now we've managed to get one in 1 minute, so let's go home. Who forgot to take their camera out of the cab? This guy. Whose cab driver drove up the road? This guy. Who panicked when he realised? This guy. I've got it back, obviously, but I'm going to end the vlog now because we're both knackered, so I think we're gonna go to bed in a minute. And my new vlog's up, so go and check it out. We went to go and see The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe, if you've seen today's and not yesterday's. I highly recommend you going to check it out. So I bought a present for Lizzie 4 or 5 weeks ago. She wanted a weighted dinosaur plush that she saw on TikTok. So I found the website, I went on there,
I'm actually going to put a picture just about here, if I can manage to do it. Just here, future Sam, just here, of what it should look like. And this is what it looks like. What even is that? Like, his nose is wonky. There's no weight to it. It's ridiculous. I opened it. I got it today and I was so excited. Came home and I was like, that doesn't look what I ordered. And opened it and he was all like squished. He was like, in the packaging. Opened him up and Lizzie just started laughing. It's not what we ordered at all, but I think she likes him because he's, what's he called? Wonkasaurus Rex. Mr. Wonkasaurus, that's his name. But on that note, I'm going to end the vlog. Thank you for going on these adventures, and I'll see you later.